further we delve into the mysteries of our universe, the more mind-blowing and unbelievable discoveries are made. Today, we're looking at 13 space facts that will change the way you look at the universe. We all know that the Sun is massive, but exactly how big it is can be pretty challenging to wrap our heads around sometimes. The Sun is a yellow dwarf star around 5 billion years old and is responsible for allowing life to flourish on Earth and sending its light and warmth to the other planets in the solar system. But did you know that if we were to take all of the mass contained within our solar system, over 99% of that mass would come from the Sun? That means all planets, asteroids, and space debris floating in our solar system make up less than a single percent of our local star system. When we look out at the night sky, we are met with thousands of stars shining across the inky blackness. Many of these stars are thousands, if not millions, of light years away from the Earth, meaning that we are seeing light from the stars that were created a long, long time ago. This is because the speed of light is constant and travels through space at speeds nearly 186,000 miles per hour, 300,000 kilometers per second. As the universe expanded after the Big Bang, points in space that were close were now growing apart faster than the speed of light. This means that the light from two stars that were born apart from each other during this expansion will never reach each other because the space in between them is growing faster than the light can travel. So there is most likely an insane number of stars whose light will never reach the Earth, and we may never be able to know what exists all the way out there. Black holes have become famous for their use in many books, movies, and other forms of media. But their lesser-known opposites, white holes, have yet to make a big splash in society. One reason this might be is that for a long time they were believed to be impossible to form due to their violation of the second law of thermodynamics. However, new studies looking into theoretical objects have discovered that in some cases, the math allows for the information of a white hole as long as there isn't even a single atom of matter within its event horizon. And because math is the language of the universe, there may still be a chance for scientists to discover that white holes do, in fact, exist. Gamma-ray bursts are the most energetic and violent outbursts that astronomers have discovered within the universe. Scientists are still working on understanding what processes lead to these bursts and figuring out all of the objects that can emit them. In terms of energy, each gamma-ray burst will emit essentially the same amount of energy for an entire supernova. However, supernovas generally emit that amount of energy over weeks, while a gamma-ray burst will release that amount of energy in seconds. These bursts are extremely dangerous, but the odds of one being pointed directly at the Earth are incredibly low. But if one was pointed towards Earth, it would cause all the nitrogen and oxygen in our atmosphere to combine into nitrous dioxide, turning the sky brown and threatening all life. The stars that light up the cosmos will all inevitably reach the end of their lives and run out of fuel. When this occurs, stellar bodies that are big enough can erupt in a gigantic supernova explosion, spewing out their outer layers into space and leaving behind a core that can collapse in on itself. This process either forms a black hole, if the core is massive enough, while smaller cores collapse into objects known as neutron stars. These stars are composed almost entirely of neutrons and rotate on their axis extremely fast. The slowest neutron stars astronomers have discovered spin 60 times every second, while the ones found in a binary star system can rotate as much as 600 times every single second. For comparison, the Earth only spins one time per day. Renewable energy is going to be the future of energy on Earth, and one of the most promising ways that we can harvest energy sustainably comes from far off our planet's surface in the center of our solar system. The Sun is essentially a massive nuclear reactor, generating an unfathomable amount of energy all the time. By taking just the solar energy that hits the tiny target of Earth, scientists calculated that the Earth received 173,000 terawatt hours of solar energy from the Sun every hour. Keep in mind that 1 terawatt is equal to 1 trillion watts. Even when we factor in the yearly energy consumption in all its forms, like coal, gas, or diesel, humanity still only used 160,000 terawatt hours. If there is a way to harvest even one fraction of the Sun's hourly energy, we would be able to power the entire globe multiple times over. The Moon is one of the most prominent features in our sky and has been the Earth's companion for nearly its entire life. Did you know that it was once much closer to our planet? When it was first captured by the planet, it orbited about 10 times closer to the surface than it is today, only about 20,000 miles, 32,000 kilometers out in space compared to its around 238,900 miles, 384,400 kilometers distance today. And this slow drifting away is still happening today. Astronomers have measured this drift recently and found that it is moving away from Earth about 3.78 centimeters a year, about 1.5 inches. This drift is due to Newton's law of conservation of angular momentum, as each of the body's gravity pulls on the other and balances out by expanding the lunar orbit to conserve the total momentum of the Earth-Moon system. How long will it take before the Moon fully breaks free of Earth's gravitational pull? We all have heard that black holes are gravitational giants whose forces are so strong that not even light can escape their clutches. But all of that may need to be re-evaluated with a new discovery, a black hole burping out of a star. Astronomers watched a black hole shred a small star a few years ago, back in 2018. Now, when black holes feed on stars, it is quite common for them to emit some radiation close to the time it absorbs new matter. But for this particular black hole, astronomers didn't see this typical outflow until years later, something they have never seen before. Now theorists are getting to work trying to open up this new dimension in the understanding of what is possible in our universe. While this is the first time astronomers have detected something like this, they now believe it may not be as uncommon as they once believed. Space agencies around the globe have put a lot of equipment into space. From satellites, probes, rockets, and space stations, all of this equipment requires a lot of moving parts to get them out of Earth's atmosphere. Parts of these parts never make it back down to the surface after they either break or are destroyed. These pieces of debris continue to orbit Earth and are added to the natural meteoroids as dangerous obstacles. There are around 23,000 pieces of debris in orbit that are larger than a softball, as well as hundreds of millions of smaller pieces that threaten the current spacecraft in orbit. Even tiny flecks of paint can cause major damage to space stations when they are traveling at speeds upwards of 17,500 miles per hour. Everyone has heard that space is an unforgiving cold place that will freeze you in a matter of seconds. While this is true in much of the space if you are far away from anything, the vacuum of space stays at an average temperature of around 450 degrees Fahrenheit, around 235 degrees Celsius. But because the average temperature is freezing cold, there are regions of space that are quite a bit warmer. It turns out, your local vicinity in space matters a lot when it comes to temperature. For instance, our Moon ranges in temperature from a frigid negative 300 degrees Fahrenheit to a boiling 220 degrees Fahrenheit above the boiling point of water. It can be hard to visualize how large the universe is in our head, but it is ridiculously big. Light is the fastest traveler in the cosmos, so you would think that it can make its way across the vast vacuum of space pretty quickly, right? But even though it can travel around the Earth around 7.5 times a single second, it takes quite a while for it to make it across any distance on a universal scale. For instance, to travel from one side of the Milky Way to the other, it will take a beam of light over 100,000 years to complete that journey. And that is just one galaxy among billions spread out across a universe that continues to grow. When you are lost, look for Polaris, the North Star, and you can at least know which direction you can travel. While this is good advice, it will need to change after a few millennia. Many people think of the solar system almost like a stationary disk that is spinning around the sun. But in actuality, our solar system as a whole is hurtling around the Milky Way, tilted at a 60-degree angle. This means our view of the night sky will change over time. However, this change will be extremely slow. We can still rely on the Polaris to point us in the right direction for at least the next 1,000 years, and after which, a new star, Gamma Cepi, will take its place as the North Star. Sagittarius A star is the supermassive black hole that sits at the center of the Milky Way. But a new study is now adding on to that well-adapted theory with additional black holes surrounding the monster at the center. Due to the gravitational forces generated by supermassive black holes, astronomers have long theorized that black holes should sink towards the center of galaxies, accumulating in large numbers. The new study, let out of Columbia University, used the Chandra X-ray Observatory to look at the central region of the galaxy, where they were able to find dozens of smaller black holes. Based on the prevalence of black holes in this small area they surveyed, the team estimates that there may be as many as 10,000 black holes accompanying Sagittarius A star. Thanks for watching. See you next time on Matter.